Governor Tate Reeves held a news conference today, briefing the public on recovery efforts after Hurricane Ida. He says that although we could have been hit harder, the storm isn't over. All that they continue to monitor it. Now, 12 News' Gary Burton reports.
The Magnolia State dodged a powerful bullet in Hurricane Ida, but Governor Tate Reeves wants to make it clear that Mississippi is not in the clear.
We continue to have, over the next 12 to 14 hours, risk of tornado threats. The worst of those remain in the southeastern most counties in our state.
The governor says the state had a lot of resources pre-positioned ahead of the storm, and power restoration is going to be a priority for worst-hit areas in South Mississippi. In the state, there has been about 50,000 homes restored, but there are still over 80,000 left without power.
It is anticipated that the National Weather Service at some point soon may issue a heat advisory for tomorrow. And so if you are without power and therefore without air conditioning, just be aware of that, that it is going to be hot.
Search and rescue crews were able to complete about 20 water rescues in Jackson, Harrison, and Hancock counties. As our friends in Louisiana suffer from the power of Ida, today Governor Reeves made the decision to release the federal assets Mississippi was given by the federal government to Louisiana. He says that on a state level, we have enough search and rescue teams to take care of ourselves for now.
And when you're in a major hurricane of this magnitude, if you can take care of yourself at the local or the state level, it's imperative that you do the right thing and let the federal assets go to where they are most needed.
Good afternoon, everybody.
Today, Governor Reeves and Mayor Shukwe Antar Lumumba and other regional governors and mayors met virtually with President Joe Biden and with FEMA. Reeves says Biden approved our pre-landfall declaration request to expand it to all 82 counties in the state. For 12 News, I'm Gary Burton, Jr.